Hi there everyone, behind me, that's the Adelaide Oval, and I'm here today to watch a day of Test cricket. And while I'm here, I want to tell you a story. It's a Numberphile-y type story about a cricketer who was, pretty much without doubt, the greatest player of all time. And his name was Don Bradman.
And he's our Don Bradman. Now I ask you, is he any good?
Now the story of his career is often told through remarkable numbers, really big ones. Yet the most important number, the one that brought his career to a bittersweet end, is the number zero. Now you see, Bradman was born in 1908, and he played 52 test matches for Australia. In addition to leading the Australian team to many famous wins, Bradman's personal career was also exceptional.
England have never won a test on this ground yet, and it doesn't look like they're going to win this one the way Bradman is batting.
You see, each time a cricketer goes out to bat, they contribute a personal score to the team's overall total. Now, to fully appreciate this story, you're going to have to understand that if a batsman's individual tally in one innings reaches 50, a half century, that's pretty special. The crowd will give them a cheer.
He completed his 50, much to the delight of the crowd.
But reaching 100, a century, is the holy grail. That'll usually get a standing ovation, the batsman acknowledging the crowd with a raised bat. Here's a century at the Adelaide Oval today. And here's Don Bradman recognising a century he once scored. Look at that, bat in the air.
Don reaches 99 and we can imagine the excitement among spectators. Then he does it.
Now, over the course of their career, a cricketer also has a batting average. That's perhaps the best yardstick of their success. And it's easy to calculate. Add together all those personal totals they make in each innings and divide by the number of times the batsman's out. Now here are some of the best batsmen of all time. You might not recognise them all, but take my word for it. These are the ones with some of the highest averages. And you can see they generally average between 50 and 60. That's considered pretty exceptional. They're getting a half century on average every time they bat. So now, what was Don Bradman's average?
And I try and get as many runs as I possibly can, and if in getting those runs I should happen to break any record, well, naturally, I'm very pleased, but I do not deliberately set out to try and break records.
Well, over his 20-year career, interrupted by World War II, Bradman accrued a series of remarkable scores, and his average soared.
That's his 200. Well done.
You can see his average there on the right, going up and down. You can see it passes 100 on a few occasions.
The Don reaches his double century, Barnes already having got his.
And going into his final test, here's the situation. Bradman had scored 6,996 runs and had been dismissed 69 times. His average, incredibly, over 100. Now remember, most cricketers dream of scoring a single century in their career. Don Bradman was about to retire, averaging a century at the highest level of the game. And here he is, going out to bat in his final match in 1948.
Enter Don Bradman, who got a great ovation.
Bradman needing just 4 runs before getting out. That'll take him to 7,000 runs overall, divided by 70 times out. That's 100 as an average. 4 measly runs for a man who averages 100 per innings. 4 runs can easily be scored with a single swipe of the cricket bat. Now, knowing it's his last innings, Bradman was given 3 cheers by his English opponents. Very sportsmanlike.
Ollie's bowling and Don playing perhaps his last test innings here.
No score here from his first ball, but that's okay. But his second ball sees the unthinkable. Out for zero, known in cricket as a duck.
Well, it isn't often you get a big hand when you make a duck, but this was different.
Bradman's average had dipped to 99.94, where it would stay frozen for all time. tantalisingly close to 100. It's gone into cricketing folklore and almost seems fitting that a player considered so invincible ended just short of something that would have been so perfect. Now you may wonder, why didn't Bradman postpone his retirement, try to remedy this? But Australia's next match was over a year away. Bradman was now 40 years old. And of course, he was now in a position where he would need to score 104 in his next innings. And that would have been a tougher ask. Now to this day, no one has come close to Bradman's average. He's so far above his peers that many consider him the most dominant athlete of any sport. But it's this image of a kind of failure in his final innings that is among the most enduring. Seeing him so fallible, it just goes to show nobody's perfect, not even Don Bradman.
Our Don Bradman, what a welcome wait for you.